Hello friends, welcome to all of you in today's lecture. I will discuss on the topic physioclinical significance of Dhatumal. So in today's lecture, I will discuss what is Dhatumal, how it is generated in the body, what are its physiological significance, how it helps in maintenance of physiological homeostasis, and what are its clinical significance. As we know that Dhatumal are the waste products which are produced during the tissue metabolism, that is during transformation of Saptadhatu, that is Rasarakta Mans made Asthi Majja Shukla, by action of their respective Dhatva. Since Dhatumal are derived from the Dhatu, so they also get affected in their imbalanced functional state, either in their Vriddhi state or in their Chaya state. The Dhatumal, they play a great role in physiological homeostasis along with the Dhatu, as the Malarupi cuff, which is produced during the transformation of Ras Dhatu. Similarly, the Pitta, which is produced during the transformation of Rakta Dhatu, it helps in digestion and metabolism. Similarly, in other physiological activities also. Thus, the Dhatumal play a significant role in diagnosis and clinical presentation of the imbalanced state of Dhatu, either their Vriddhi or in their Chaya state. So let us see that how Acharya has described about the tissue metabolism and how the Dhatumal are produced during the transformation of different tissues. He has given the verse Tat ahar prasadakhyo rasah kittam cha malakhya abhinivartante kittat swet mutra purish vat pitta shleshmana karna akshi nasika asya lom kupa prajanan mala ke shramashi lom nak adesh avyava pushyam. In the first line he refers that ahar, that is the food which we ingest, when it gets completely digested in the GIT with the help of different dosh, that is the prana vata dosh, then saman vata dosh, similarly the pachak pitta and bodhak kapha and kleda kapha. So with the help of these three tridosh, the food, it gets completely digested and divides into two parts, prasad and kitta bhag. Prasada akhyo rasa, prasada bhag is also called as ras, and kitta part, that is the waste part, it is also called as mal. The kitta part, it replenishes to the swet, that is sweat, mutra, urine, purish, feces, vata pitta shlesham, that is tridosh, karna, ear, akshi, eye, nasika, nose, asya, oral mouth, oral cavity, lobe, koop, hair follicles, prajanan mala, the secretions in the genitalia. So the secretions present in all these parts, they are generated during the tissue metabolism and they are replenished by the kit part of the ahar. Similarly, kesh shamashru, kesh hairs over the scalp, shramashru, beard, loam, hairs over the body, nakh, nails. So all these get nourished by the kit and they are produced at the level of digestion, that is mutra and purish, and during the metabolism of Rasarakta Mans mein Asthi Majja Shukra by their respective Agni, this tridosh and these mal, they are produced and they are nourished by the kit part of the ahara. The rest part, it nourishes to the different dhatu पुष्यन्ति त्वा आहार रसात् रुधिर मांस मेदो अस्थि मज्जा शुक्र औजांसि पंचेन्द्रिय द्रव्याणि धातु प्रसाद संज्ञकानि शरीर संधि बंध पिच्छा आदेश अवयव. सो द आहार रस दैट इज द प्रसाद भाग इट नरिशेस टू द सेवन टिश्यूज ओज पंचेन्द्रिय द्रव्य दैट इज द शब्द स्पर्श रूप रस गंध. So the food, it is made up of five panchamahabhut. It gets disintegrated into its simpler form and into their respective guna. So the these guna, they are nourished by their respective panchamahabhut guna. Sarira sandhi, that is the joints, bandha, pitcha, adha, avayasya. So all the fluid-like secretions, they are get nourished by the aharas. Te sarva eva dhatiyo malakshya prasad akshya ras malayam pushyanta swam manam anuvartate yatha vaya shariram. Here Acharya Charaka expresses that similar to the ahara, as ahara gets divided into the ras and kitta bhaga by action of pachak pitta or pachak agni, in the same manner the dhatu, that is rasaktamans midasti majja shukra, they also get divided into two parts by the action of their respective agni, into prasada bhag and malabhag, prasadayak and rasmalabhyam. And the prasada bhag nourishes to the respective tissue and its little bit fraction nourishes to the next dhatu also, and the malabhag nourishes to its dhatu mal, which is formed at the level of each dhatu. And swam manam anuvartate, the deformation or the transformation of the dhatu, it happens in their respective quantity. And yathavaya shariram means it also depends on the age of the body. So as we know that tissue metabolism, definitely it depends on the age factor also, and each tissue is replenished as per the normal quantity in the body. एवं रसमलो स्वप्रमाण अवस्थित आश्रयस्य समधातु धातु साम्य अनुवर्तिनः. So in this manner, the formed ras and mal part during the tissue metabolism. So ras adi means here the ras rakta mans means asti majja shukra and the mal part. All these are formed in their respective pramar, that is in the their normal quantity, and they retain in their respective ashraya means in their respective sites. Then they maintain the tissue homeostasis and the physiology. However, if nimittastu chira vriddhya nam prasadakhya nam dhatu nam vriddhi chaya abhyam ahara mula abhyam rasa samutpadya arogya. So the quantity, that is the either the tissue or the aha, the tissue waste product, it will be in their lesser quantity, chida, or it may be in excess, mrid. It depends on the ahara mula bhyam. So we know that the whole tissue and is nourished by the aharas, and the kitta part is going to nourish the waste, which is formed at the level of GIT or which is formed at the level of tissues. All is being nourished by the aharas, which is formed by the food which we intake. So basically all these things depend on the quality of ahar or diet which we take. Swaman atirikta punar utsargina. So if the mal, it is formed in excess, it is excreted out from the body, and in a state of its chheena or vridha avastha, that is its, when it is formed in less quantity or in it is in excess, so accordingly we use the गुरुवादी गुण कंटेनिंग डिफरेंट फूड आइटम्स दैट इज द शीत उष्ण लघु गुरु और स्निग्ध रुक्ष स्थिर सर सो ऑल दीज आर द गुरुवादी प्रॉपर्टीज विच आर प्रेजेंट इन फूड ऑल्सो सो अकॉर्डिंगली वी अप्लाई द फूड एंड टू मेंटेन द फिजियोलॉजिकल होम्योस्टैसिस ऑफ द टिश्यूज Again, in Charakchikitsa, the same thing told by the Acharya Charak again. Saptvi de dhataro dhato dividham puna yatha sum agnivi pakam yanti kritta prasadavat. Means, the seven tissues, they get divided into two parts. Dhato dividham puna. By the action of their respective dhatu agni, swa agnivi pakam yanti kritta prasadavat. So the by the action of the respective dhatu agni over the dhatu, it gets transformed. Pakam means its metabolism or its transformation into two parts, that is kit and prasad bhag, ke waste part and its nutrient part. Now how the different waste products are formed, we have just now discussed. So what are the waste products which are formed at the level of seven tissues? Pittam mannasya vidu mutram rasasya tukafo ashraja pittam mansasya khamala mala swadhistu medasaha shyat pittam kesh lomastano majya sneho achi vidu tvacham prasadi kitte dhatu nam paka devam dharchada prasad parasparopa sanstabda dhatu ishne parampara. So the kittam annasya, the kit of anna is vidu mutra. Vid means feces, mutra means urine. Rasasya tukafo ashraja and the mal of ras is kapha, asraja means rakta, and of rakta is pitta. So the ras dhatu has two mal, kapha dosh and lasika. Acharya Vagbhat has given lasika as a mal of ras also. Rakta, pitta dosh, mansa, khamala, mansasya khamala. Khamala, that is ear wax, or Chakrapani has further explained is that the secretions which are present in different external orifices, kha means space. So the open orifices or the openings of the body are eye, nose, mouth and the genitalia. So the secretions in eye, nose, genitalia, urethra, coating over the tongue and teeth. All these things could be understood as a mans mal, main is swed. Mala swedastu medasa asti. Hair on the scalp, body, beard and nail. Keshilum asthanu. This is of asti. Majja, unctuousness in eye and skin and physique. Ishneu akshi vita tvacha. Unctuousness, akshi means eye, vit means physique, tvacha means skin. And shukra has no mal. Oj is considered as a mal of shukra by Acharya Vagbhat. This, although the it is considered that at the level of shukra, when the shukra agni acts over the shukra dhatu, there is no mal is formed at all. But here Acharya Vagbhat has considered oj as a mal of shukra dhatu in relation to the garb. He says that the garb is the prasad of shukra dhatu, and in relation to that garb, here oj is considered as mal of shukra dhatu. Although oj is not considered as a mal, because there is a reason that the if there is a chay or vriddhi of any dhatu or mal, it causes disorders or vikar in the body. Whereas the oj chay causes vikar, but the oj vriddhi, it never causes any kind of disorder within the body. It only produces beneficial effects even in the vriddhi state also. Acharya Sharangadhar has also given the waste products which are formed at the level of Sapta Dhatu, and they are little bit different from the Dhatu Mal which are given by Acharya Charak, Shrushut and Vagbhat. So the mal of ras is jihva nail kapola nam jalam. Jihva netra kapola nam. So the moisture in eye, mouth, and tongue. So the water secretion in the eye, mouth, and tongue could be considered as the jal, and it is the mal of ras dhatu. Whereas pittam cha ranjikam, mal of rakt is ranjak pitt. Not pit, here he has specified the it is the ranjak pit which is the mala rakta dhatu, and it is more scientific. And the man's earwax, kamal, made sweat, that is suede, excretions in nose, genital, urethra, coating over the tongue and teeth. Asana danta kaksha med adij malam. Then asthi, nails and hairs, majja, excretions of eye, unctuousness on the eye and face. So here netravit, twakshu cha snehu, dhatu nam kramso mala, shukra yuvan pedika, that is acne in the adolescence. So here Acharya Sharangadhar has given the mal of shukra dhatu as a pidika, that is yuvan pidika. So we know that under the effect of androgens, that is the sex hormones during the puberty, there is formation of acne. So this may be the reason why Acharya Sharangadhar has considered pidika as a mal of shukra dhatu. Now the generation of dhatu mal during tissue transformation here. Acharya Shushrut has given the verse, rasad raktam tato mansam mansanna medha prajayate, medhas tato asthi tato majja shukram tu jayate. In this verse he explains that the ras rakt mans medh asthi majja shukra, they get nourished in a sequential manner. Rasat raktam, from the ras, rakt is nourished. From the rakt, mans, mans, from mans, medh is nourished. From med, asti is nourished, and from asti, majja is nourished, from majja, shukra is nourished. So Acharya Dhanlal has further explained that rasadi nam mal stool adu bhaga visheshena trividha parinamo bhavati, means when the rasagni acted over the rasadhatu, then it gets divided into three parts. Rasadni अग्नि पक्व अन्न मलह पक्वान्न मलह कफ स्थूल भागो रस अड़ु भागो रक्तम. इट गेट्स डिवाइडेड इनटू थ्री पार्ट, दैट इज मल पार्ट, कफ, स्थूल भाग. मेजर पोर्शन इज रस व्हिच नरिशेस टू द रस. अड़ु भाग, इट्स अ स्मॉल फ्रैक्शन, इट नरिशेस टू द नेक्स्ट धातु, दैट इज रक्त धातु. So in the same manner, all the tissues when acted upon by their respective agni, they get divided into three parts and there is generation of mal. But further Acharya Dhanlal has explained here that there is the sequential transformation of tissue, it doesn't happen in after birth. This transformation or this pattern of nourishment refers to the embryonic stage of tissue transformation and nutrition. We know that when the zygote is formed, it is single cell, and that cell has capacity to differentiate into any kind of cell. So during that, all the cells, they get nourished by the ras, and they get differentiated into different kind of tissues. Once they get differentiated into the different specific kind of tissue, then they do not get converted or transformed into another kind of tissue. So basically this refers to the tissue transformation and nutrition during the embryonic life or during the organogenesis. Here he says prajayate iti pravartata iti pathante shukram tu jayate sukrasya sambhava. So sambhava sabdo artha poshane na purvut padane, means he explains that all the tissues, they get nourished and replenished only नॉट दे आर फॉर्म फ्रॉम द प्रीवियस धातु यतो रसादीनाम सुक्रांतानाम गर्भादीनेव उत्पत्ति इति सो द रस आदि दे आर ओनली रिप्लेनिश्ड बाय द आहार रस आफ्टर द बर्थ ऑफ द बेबी मीन्स वंस द there is intake of any kind of food just after birth, then there is formation of aharas and all the form tissues, they are replenished and nourished by the aharas only, and one kind of tissue do not get transformed into another kind of tissue. Rather, it refers to the interdependence of the metabolism of different kind of tissues, as the Medha Dhatu, for its metabolism, it depends on the Asthi Dhatu also. So we know the formation of bone, it requires various hormones which get synthesized by the Medha. Cholesterol is Medha and vitamin D is synthesized by the cholesterol, and various other hormones are there, like the different kind of leptins and different kind of adipokines, which help in osteogenesis and osteoblastic activity. So in this manner, we can say that all the tissues, they are interdependent on each other for their metabolism and their homeostasis. But one type of tissue do not get converted into another type of tissue. Here, Acharya, this Sivadasen has also given commentary. Janyascha poshanam eva vartate na purvutpadane yato raktadeyo garbhat prabhityo utpanna rasadi bhi poshyant. The same thing he also expresses, that there is only the nourishment and replenishment and na purvotpade, the next dhatu do not get derived from the previous one. Now here we see that how the dhatu mal are derived by respective dhatu agni during the tissue transformation. Here this is the ras dhatu. When it is acted upon by the ras agni, it gets divided into sarabhag and malbhag, as I earlier discussed. Then the sarabhag divides into two parts. The major part nourishes to the ras dhatu or replenishes to the ras dhatu, and its small fraction it nourishes to the rakta dhatu. It helps in nourishment of the rakta dhatu. Whereas the mal is kapha. In the same manner, when rakta agni is acted upon by rakta dhatu is acted upon by the rakta agni, it gets divided into sar and malabhag, and the major part replenishes to the rakt, and its small fraction nourishes to the mans dhatu, and mal is pith. So in the same manner, in all the dhatu level, there is generation of mal. Like in the mans, the kamal, made swed, asti, nakakesha, loom, beer. Similarly in majja, unctuousness in eye, skin and feces, shukra, that is garbh and oj. Now what is first mal is kaf, that is malarupi. It is also called as malarupi kaf or vakrit kaf. So for the understanding of dosh, Acharya Vagbhat has given that the dosh are of two kind, prakrit dosh and vakrit dosh. The prakrit dosh are the dosh, they are also called as dhatu. They are responsible for formation of sapta tatra prakritiya sapta vidhaya prakriti hetu bhuta sarirek janmana. So these prakrit dosh, they are responsible for determination of prakriti at the time of formation of zygote. So the prakrit dosh, they come into the zygote from the sperm and ova, and they remain all through the life. So in the proportion in which Vata Pitta Kapha, they are formed into the zygote, that proportion is retained all through the life, and that is all called as Prakrit Dosh, and they are responsible for formation of Prakriti. And they have been considered as Dhatu, Prakrita, Sarir Ek Jinmana, Sattva Sarir Dharane Dhatu Sanya Labhate. So the Prakrit Dosh, they are all have been considered as Dhatu Sanya because they do not produce any kind of disorder. And Prakrita, Dosh Sanya Ka Naam, Vakrita Naam, Vatadi Naam, Bejibhuta, Techa Prakrita Yena, Mumurstapsya Swaparupan Chalanti, Yavat Jivit Maranena Swarupa Ityartha. Ye to Janmana Uttar Kala Sambhuti Te Vakrita. Here he says that the Prakrit Dosh, it has been considered as Bijabhuta, means they are coming from the sperm and ova, and they retain all through the life, means Jivit Maranam, means all through the life. And the dosh which are produced after birth from the ahar, they are called as Vakrit Dosh. So Vakritastu Garbhadi Nisritasya Aharasya Mala Sambhavanti Prakritte Shev Avarohanti. So the Vakrit Dosh, they are produced from the ahar as a mal, and they help in maintenance of Prakrit Dosh. They replenish, they help in maintenance of Prakrit Dosh, as well as they help in maintenance of the normal physiology of the body. And the Vakrit Dosh te kal adi vashena swa pramana vritthaya chay yoga ta deham anugrahanti doshayanti cha. So the malrupi dosh, when they are produced, they are liable to change in their quality and quantity. Swa pramana vritthi chay yoga, because they are produced from the ahar. So the quality and quantity of the dosh, it depends on the type of food which we take, and the quality of food, and the code of conduct, vihar, the level activity of the body. So it depends on so many factors. Kal te kala adivashin, kal means the time factor, that is the season, age, day, night. So and Dushyanti cha, if they get vitiated because of improper diet and activity, so they produce disorder also. That's why they are called as dosh. So basically, this Vakrit dosh, which are produced from the ahara, they are called as dosh, and they depend on the ahara. Kapho avastha pakatarasmaltaya cha bhavati. So the kapha, it is also released during the first phase of digestion, that is madhuravastha paka. Madhuradyat kapho bhavata fena bhutam udiryate. So thus the malrupi kapha nourishes to the prakrit kapha and help in physiological functions, produced during the vipaka, that is during the process of aharas. Once the food is digested, aharas gets reabsorbed, and then it is acted upon by the bhutagni, and after that there is conversion into the aharas, and that during that time there is formation of ras and formation of malrupi kapha, and that formed kapha is released during the first phase of digestion, that is called madhuravasthapa. And the quantity of malarupi kapha, it changes with the type of diet, lifestyle, season, and it follows a circadian rhythm. So this is about the malarupi kapha, which is produced during the vipak, that is the during the transformation of aharas, and from that the ras gets nourished and kapha is formed. Next mal of ras is lasika. So Acharya Vagbhat is considered lasika or it is also called as lymph in contemporary sciences, as a mull of prasadhatu. So what is lasika? Yattu tvag antre vradagatam lasika sabdam labhate dash undakasya anjaleya. So the quantity of udak in the body is 10 anjali, and when this the fraction of udak it comes or it oozes out from any injured site over the skin as an exudate, then that udak is called as lasika. This lasika is also a dwelling site of pitta. Nabir amashaya shvedo lasika rudhiram rasah drik sparshanam cha pittasya nabir atra visheshita. And the here lasika has been considered as a water like substance, lasika jal shadishi. So basically it is lasika is the fraction of udak, that is water, which oozes out from the injured site in the skin as an exudate. It is also a dushya. It gets vitiated in prameha, that is in diabetes. So this is about the lasika, and it is the mull of kapha. So thank you, and the rest of dhatu mull we will discuss in the next lecture.